what I'm listening to Duran Bernard. This is from that Terrell's 1 million, when he hit 1 million subscribers. I haven't had Mountain Dew in almost, it's been a long time. Well, actually, no, I'm not gonna lie. I had Mountain Dew at Comic-Con. But I won Baja Blast. I had it at Comic-Con because I won a Baja Blast. I didn't buy it, so. They were doing a giveaway and they had like sodas, and I ended up landing on Baja Blast, and I was like, okay, well, I guess I'll just take it. It's free. Yes, I'm still going live. I do want to try Poppy. I think that's the one I've been seeing everywhere, so I'm going to try that. I do like SZA. Oh, you know what? I will play a SZA song. My day was good, sort of. I woke up feeling sick again, so I took cough medicine because I had a bad cough. And I seem to be doing good. So I heard there was an earthquake in New Jersey and New York, and that must have been scary for some people. Where I live, we don't get I'm missing something, guys. Where I live, we don't get earthquakes or tornadoes. We get flooding. That's what we get. We don't get hurricanes either, but we do get floods. So. No, I'm not looking at apartments because I don't want to get an apartment right now. They're, yeah. So.
When they asked me, why would I let
Lizzie? A house is like. Oh no, someone's subscription is going.
She wants to do.
I listen to Drake.
You're a professional athlete, like every day.
Hey, Ricky. Yeah.
That's what makes it so hard.
No, we don't have a foster puppy. So the puppy was never ours. So you guys know that. Yeah, that was not our dog. Sorry. I know what song I'm gonna play. No, I cannot get a dog. It's too soon. Way too soon. And right now, where we're living, we cannot afford a dog. I can't afford the pet fees, so. I'm not trying to cause way more expenses. No, I haven't been to the gym because they were closed. Okay, so there was a community center we were going to, but they were closed for what is it? It's like spring break or something. Not spring break, but there's something for the kids. The only thing that's open was the gym, but I don't have workout clothes yet. I might get free workout clothes to try for you guys from a TikTok shop. So we'll see. Because I need workout clothes and stuff, and there's a lot of stuff that. There wasn't. Where we were going because there was something for all of us to do, but we all didn't have anything to do, so we just left because my brother usually shoots hoops. And it was just like the only thing that was open was the gym, and I'm like, yeah, I don't want to work out and then have to shower, and then it's just, I'm gonna have to find a place closer to me or find somewhere where I can go, like a community center that's free. But I don't have like a ride because my brother's busy doing stuff. I don't want an apartment. Dang, that was loud. I don't want an apartment. I kind of scared. I thought something was falling from the sky. Because a lot of the apartments that are available have bad reviews. And all the good ones, no one's moving from. So, I would rather much just get a house than just settle for an apartment with roaches. I'm not gonna live at an apartment that's roach infested because it's available. A lot of them say, we have roach infestations. I'm like, I don't want to go through another roach infestation again. Our last apartment had that. I just want to own a house and be comfortable. I don't want to have to keep moving and keep moving and keep moving and eventually move into a house. I want to have a house. I'm tired of moving. I am tired of moving around. That's your choice. That's your thought that I don't have money. I'm not telling people what I'm doing. So it's none of your business what I'm doing to get a house. And no, I'm not getting a loan because I don't want to pay a loan back. I think this is that. What is it? Picture frame TV? I think that new TV, because when I HDMI when the switch is not on, it literally shows like a picture frame and like art paintings and stuff. What is it? Oil paintings. That's why I think it's. I had to play this all. Apparently, SZA's a compulsive liar. I don't know. I didn't see that video. There's that guy that watches my live, you know, who, Sloan, he made a video on SZA, and apparently SZA has been caught lying. I didn't know, but, oh, you know what? Let's play this playlist, because, how does YouTube know me? You know me so well, though. I was like, they know me so well. No, I'm not doing van life. Nope. I cannot live on the road. Is that the first one? Because if that is, I'll be like, yeah. We can afford a van. We can afford an RV if we wanted to. We most certainly could. But I don't want that. How I'm going to have money to get a house. I'm not telling anyone anything because it's nobody's business. Like, please stop trying to pry into my business. It's my business. Same here, Ricky. Same. Buy a trip. The comet flew. No, I don't even know. Money doesn't. It does when you're buying a house. Yeah, you tell him, Ricky. Tell him. There's no plan. Yes, there is. When you're buying a house, you have to have a plan. You can't just say, I'm going to buy a house. If you say, I'm going to buy a house, that's not going to work. You have to have money. Houses aren't free. And plus, it's not a good time in the housing market to buy a house. But when I'm able to, I will. I was gonna build a house, but I'd rather buy a house. Building a house, we'd have to wait for it to be finished being built. My credit score is nothing. I have to build my credit score. So, I was given some really good advice, and I'm going to be building my credit. So, I actually have, I don't even have bad credit at all. Or good credit. I have no credit. I checked my credit score, and so I'm going to build my credit. Well, no, it's not bad, because if it's not bad and if it's not good, and I have no credit, that's good because I can build my credit. Where if it was really bad, it's hard to build your credit from bad credit. Like, it's hard to fix your credit. But I can just, I know what I need to do, and I'm gonna do it, so... I'm a 30-year-old. No, I'm 29. I'm almost 30. And, like, what's that got to do with anything? That me being 30 has nothing to do with nothing. No. I do not want to live in a trailer. Nothing wrong with living in a trailer, but not for me. And a trailer sometimes runs off of propane. And it's not a lot cheaper. A trailer is kind of expensive. When my friend was alive, she won a free trailer and had to give it away because she couldn't afford to live in it. That was probably a while ago, but still, now I believe it would be a lot harder to live in a trailer. No, I understand what, like, you guys doubt that I'm getting a house, but I'm working on it. I'm not gonna tell people how I'm getting a house. I understand you don't want me to get a house. You want me to fail, but I'm not going to. Yes, you tell him. A house with my money? Monopoly money. You didn't know that if you have millions of dollars in Monopoly money, I still have money in the bank from the last time we played Monopoly. I kept it. I saved it. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to save this money to buy a house. That's how you buy a house. Monopoly money. I'm just kidding. No, what did it do? It clicked out. We already heard this song. Next. probably. What feeders? I'm confused. It's frozen. Oh, there we go. This, I think she's the one that died from cancer. No, I filed a police report. I think I know who might have stole my Android, but I can't definitively accuse them, but I think they took it. When they had the opportunity, when they were able to have access to my brother's car, I think they took it. And the only reason why I believe they took my Android is because they were the only one that could have seen or gotten access to my code. And not only that, to me, no random person would be able to get into that phone without a code, right? It had to have been someone who knew the code. They transferred $8 to their bank account, and I got their information. And I have their information. the last four digits of their credit card number. That is very stupid of you to transfer $8 to your bank and not think I was gonna not have, like, I'm gonna notify the police that I have your information. I don't know what you thought you was accomplishing by stealing my stuff. And if they factory reset the phone, the apps wouldn't have been on there, so they wouldn't have been able to get to the Cash App and transfer money to the Cash App. There's no way they would have. When you factory reset a phone, all the apps go away, right? So it had to have been someone who knew the code, someone who watched me open my phone, so they would have the opportunity one day to take the phone, because I kind of have my reasons why I think they took the phone, but I can't definitively accuse someone, allegedly, because I can't go around calling someone a thief if I didn't see them take it. But there's no way it fell out of my brother's car. I didn't hear it. I didn't lose it anywhere. I left it in the side door, the passenger side door of my brother's car, because I didn't need it at all. I was taking it to charge it, and then I said, well, I'm not charging it. So what's the point of just bringing it? I'll just leave it. Because I said, it's gonna get lost or stolen. And then I said, well, when I realized it was missing, I said, well, maybe it's lost somewhere in the car. You know, I'll just look for it. When I woke up the morning after I had realized it was, like, missing, I had saw someone took $8 out of my Cash App, and that's when I knew. I was like, yep. And it literally, okay, so when I traced the phone, it traced it in between somewhere. Then it traced it to a place where a person was staying. And yeah, that kind of raised my suspicions even more. But then I was like, we stayed here, so I don't know if it's tracing it here, because I had it in Google Maps because we've lived here before. But no. Now I believe it traced it there because that person had it. And when I literally left a note after I locked it from the it's not where's my phone, but it's the Google Find My Google Phone or whatever. I said, give me my phone back. The police knows where it's at. Because it traced it, and I did tell the police. When I called the non-emergency number and I said, give me my phone back. The police knows where it's at. All of a sudden, I couldn't trace it anymore. They must have smashed the phone to pieces, broke it, or they possibly, right? They must have smashed the phone to pieces, or they shut it off, and they're leaving it off because they don't want it to be traced. But trust me, I know exactly where it was traced, and I know exactly who lives there. And I will be notifying the police that I did trace it in that area, and actually it's still in my tabs, exactly right where it traced it. So, you're gonna get in serious trouble by me personally, I shouldn't accuse someone of stealing, but, you know, I haven't had a good interaction with that person, so what am I supposed to think? Well, kind of allegedly. It's funny how you guys are saying names, and I didn't even mention a name, so. Yeah, I mean, you could say whoever, but I'm not telling you if it is or isn't. Because I'm not talking about that person. Hey guys. I don't know if she sold the phone or not, because obviously it's off. And even if she sold the phone, if you're saying she, as referring to that A word, I'm not talking about her. But if this person, even if she, because I believe it is a she that took my phone, sold the phone, no, they can't get into it because it's locked. And when they do get that phone, it's going to say the police know that this phone is being traced. So whoever they sold it to literally is going to know that it's stolen. The message is there. I blocked them out of the phone. And if they thought they got any information, all you got was screenshots of stuff from the Discord and screenshots of stuff about you and screenshots and stuff about Pleasant and Leslie. So you didn't get nothing on that phone. I didn't even use that phone. My search history is not even on that phone. But nice try. They thought they were doing something. I just know if any information comes out that no one knew except what was in my Android, and someone starts talking, I'll share some information on you. So I would suggest you wouldn't do that, because it won't be wise. Two can play that game. People think that they got me, but they don't. Like, okay, you want to be an idiot and admit you stole someone's Android? Come on now. First it was a cell phone, then it was tissue paper. My brother's Kleenex went missing. My brother has this like little section where you can put Kleenex in his car. And he was like, oh, can you give me some Kleenex? And I was like, I'm sorry, you don't have it. It's gone. He was like, it's right there. And then he realized it was gone. That's funny, stealing someone's Kleenex. That's the only place it was on my side. Not the clean.
I didn't have toilet paper.
His Kleenex disappeared, and I was like, because it was on my side, and I don't use the Kleenex except if I have to wipe my hands or something when I'm eating something. But it was gone, and he told me, I put it right there, and I was like, no, your Kleenex is missing. He looked, it was missing. I'm telling you, little things started going missing. It's not really that funny, but it's kind of funny. What do you think? Wait, what? You mean that cosplayer minor that is creepy, that looks like me, and literally scared the hell... Well, they did scare the hell... I'm terrified of that person, because They look exactly like me, and it's scary. It's not even flattering. It's scary. Like, stop. You and your mother have been harassing me for years. Didn't your mom say she was gonna call the FBI on me because I said she was a fake nurse because she was diagnosing me on a live stream? On UpLive, saying that I think she has personality disorder because I'm a nurse, and even a known nurse said that they literally didn't like that you was doing that, and they were gonna tell you off, that that's not cool what you're doing as a nurse, and they're also a nurse. Yikes. This girl that has been, this girl has had a bunch of Twitter accounts talking about incest, pretending to be me, saying I slept with my brother, I slept with my father, saying nasty stuff, like real disgusting, real nasty stuff. Just, it is very nasty things they were saying on Twitter and tagging me on my original Twitter. So I blocked their accounts. They started spam tweeting me. Then they were telling me to take down my TikTok account, or telling people to mass report my TikTok account because they were mad. They live in their grandma's house that unfortunately passed away because they can't afford to live anywhere else. They live in a house that was given to them by their grandmother, her and her mom, which the mother is allowing the minor to harass me while talking incest. And talking about my private parts, which is nasty, a minor, talking about my body on Twitter. That's gross. You let your daughter do that? You let your daughter do that. And then say you're gonna call the FBI on me because you're harassing me. And left a message on my phone when I had my home phone, when people were spam calling on my home phone when we lived at my old apartments. Saying, I'm going to call the FBI on you. You're harassing me. And your daughter's talking about my private parts on Twitter. And I was so uncomfortable that I asked you to stop. This person is still probably cosplaying me. Looked like me, because I was confused for a second. I was like, wait, when did I make this video? And I was like, that was someone else. And I was like, that's terrifying. That's like not even flat. That's not even flattering. It's weird. Like, you've been talking about my private parts on Twitter as a minor. That's nasty. And I ask people not to do that because it's making me uncomfortable. And then they won't leave me alone. They just keep harassing me and thinks it's cute. And the mother's in on it with the daughter. Like, how are you going to let your daughter talk like that on Twitter? Someone needs to look into it and take your child away. If I had a child like that talking like that all over Twitter, someone would be calling CPS and be like, why is her daughter talking like that on Twitter? You need to look into that. It's disgusting. But hey. Like, whatever. That's why I don't mention that person, because they're a stalker. I just block them off of Twitter and keep moving, because anytime someone keeps sending me that video, I'm like, don't, because I don't engage with them. They don't stop. They've been harassing me since all this went down like 4 years ago. They're like amongst however many other harassers I have. Like, I don't want any parts of that. Like, no. We are not gonna... I'm not playing that. I saw that and I was like, get off my screen, R. Kelly. I believe I could fly. No. The only thing you flew to was jail. And that's where you should stay. Okay? Jail. J-A-I-L. Yeah, my mom's okay, guys. You keep asking that. I don't know how many times to tell you she has overactive thyroids. She's going to be coughing like that because of her thyroids. Okay, let's play this song. takes an acid before she eats, then she... What was they gonna play? Oh. I know which one. Can I type? There it is. You know me too well. YouTube. No. I don't want to hear Nicki Minaj. Thank you. Please. We are not hearing that. I don't like JoJo Siwa's new song, guys. I'm sorry. And I heard, I kept hearing it on Instagram because of not my own choice. My favorite Family Guy character. Oh. My favorite Family Guy episodes are the one where he fights the chicken. He's always has it because, okay, so how it supposedly all started with the chicken, which I think is funny to me, is because the chicken gave him an expired coupon. That's what. Ever since then, he remembered when the chicken gave him an expired coupon. And so that's why he fights the chicken. I would be that old guy for Family Guy. That was not funny. That was actually hurtful. This song does make me sad too. It reminds me of that movie, The Longest Ride, kind of. With Scott Eastwood. I want to watch a K-drama and be sad with popcorn. I'm going to see if I can download the browser on my, the internet browser on my Switch and put a K-drama on. I have a place where I can watch free K-dramas. Anyone I want. No, I'm not 30 yet. Not until June. And that's not even that far off. We're in April. 2 months, my birthday. Jesus Christ. It's going by so fast. Stop, slow down. Pretty soon will be July. 4th of July is almost coming up again. And then it'll be November and December. Like, this year's going by fast. Slow down. Oh. One day you'll wake up. Never mind. I'm not gonna think about that. The second day of WrestleMania, probably not tomorrow because I'm not paying for WrestleMania. Someone's gonna stream it, but they're gonna stream the second day. Unless there's like people streaming WrestleMania, then probably. I won't find love this year. I'm sorry, guys. I'm gonna be single forever. Sadly, that's what I believe. Oh Lord, I have the bad hiccups. True. See, you agree. Thank you. by you, lovelies all. My only one. Yes, I do want kids. Ugh. Is there any good new K-dramas out there, guys, to watch? That's what I want to know. Try dating apps. No, I hate dating apps. I hate them with a passion. And as you guys know, because you... What happened to manifesting in K-pop idols? When did I ever say that? I don't remember saying that. Because of that one joke I made, it was a joke. There was a song I was gonna play. What's his name? I have his in my head, but I can't think of his name. I keep wanting to say Callum Worthy. It's not. It is a joke. I don't want to date an idol. Do you know what would happen? Do you know what happens to people that date idols? First of all, if you have not seen people make videos about dating idols, you should. It's on YouTube. There's plenty of videos. And first of all, their schedule is not built for them to date anyone. And then also death threats. I do not want to receive. There's a lot of stuff. It's not secretive. It's in the public. Even if like right now, because I have a large platform, right? And I am somewhat like people know me. I could still kind of keep a relationship private. I could be dating someone right now and people wouldn't even know if I wanted to. But definitely, if you're dating a celebrity to that status, it cannot. It'll be made public. Someone always knows. It's not exciting. What's his name? And I follow him too. Does he sing this song? And actually, it's funny that people think I live in a motel because I don't live in a motel. Okay, anyways. No. Why does it always click? I think... Is that what it is? This wasn't the song I was gonna play. There's a song... I think he... Hold on. There it is. I think. No. Who is Lou? I've never heard of Lou. Thank you. Here we go. This song. That's a sad music video.
They taste so good. Your family will say something else.
So where am I? I'm in a house in the middle of the forest. In the mountains. I'm in a cabin in the mountains. Guys. We went on vacation. I'm just kidding. But I have stayed in the mountains before, a long time ago when I was little, in elementary school, and I rode a horse. Oh, why did I have to watch this video? Why did I have to watch this video? My mom is fine. She has water right there, too. She doesn't like cough drops. That's why we don't have any. Why did I play this song? Why? I know. I should. This was the wrong song to play. This is the wrong song to play. Cause the video is so sad. It's the one where the owner dies and the dog knows. So he always goes to his grave. Well, I care, and especially someone who didn't lose a human, who lost a dog. It's sad. Don't laugh, okay. It's not even early. It's not even early. Hold on, guys. Oh. Let me play this a little while. Why was she crying? I was not crying. I was just sad because of the video of the dog. I wasn't going to play this one, but I guess I'll play this one. And I'll play the other one. It was the Louis Capaldi one that, remember, I made a video to when everyone was reacting to the video. What is it? Late Night Talking. I couldn't even think. I was like, what is this song? I forgot. I don't deserve to listen to yourself. I'm rude. I be a baby. Make the selling. You know what? I know a song I'll play. Thank you for the heart, me. You're in my life. I can't get you off my mind. I really wish I would have saw him on tour. Coming to. I don't like karma. Thank you for the gifts, baby. Make you happy, baby. Houdini by Dua Lipa. I could play that. I don't take song requests. God, because then people start complaining. They're like, skip this, I don't like it. Song named Late Night Talking, Harry Styles. Talking, whatever. My mom's not cooking. She's running the sink. Because she's probably washing out silverware because we just used it. I don't know what she's doing. Get you off my mind. She's gonna use. I do like Houdini. When I reacted to it, which I think it might, that might have been the one with Megan Thee Stallion that got taken down because copyright. But yeah. I think it's a good song. First of all, let's play this one. There we go. Not Mercy. Oh, there it is. If you hear that whistling sound, that's because it's really windy outside. Wayfair supports a genocide. Didn't know that. I found out I didn't know that. I froze. Hairstyle supports a genocide? I didn't know that. I don't know anything. No, it's gonna freeze.
Just as a snake
shit. It's not gonna play. Let me go back there.
Just as a snake sheds his skin, you must shed our past over and over.
Yes, make it. Hey, turn the C. I already know someone's gonna be like, yeah, skip. I have to hear that part again. Why do you guys keep saying Mitski? I don't play song requests, I'm sorry. Forgot. I didn't take a request. Someone said make the sound, and so I said, ooh, because I really wanted to hear this one. You really fell off. You fell off. Your mom fell in. Hell. I'm just kidding. Ha. I'm just kidding. Funny.
I got rid of
it.
Well, you only have
them. I ain't take like a nut. Bongo bongo. Oh.
Whoa. I'm almost at 30. We should try to bump those numbers up to 30. We gotta get those numbers up.
There we go. It had 27 viewers, yeah.
Cantina chicken burrito isn't just for late night. Because it
if I was talking about drama, people would get movie in here. Shrek Jr. Funny. Not really. Yes, I do like Lana Del Rey. I know what Ram Ranch is, guys. Come on now. I hope this song that I picked for my label does good. On fan label. You guys should get fan label. You play trivia and you gotta save whatever points you save. You get actual prizes like records. You can get a record player. Merch, a bunch of stuff on there. It's really cool. I didn't believe it because he was like, I'm getting free items from this app. And I was like, that's a lie. It's not. Yeah, I do have a label. I know the words to this song. I listen to it a lot. Joseph with new song thoughts. I don't like it. It's catchy. I will give that to her, but yeah, why do people dislike me? Well, there's videos out there that make me look bad. That's why they dislike me. And I always tell people that because people think that I tell people there's no videos out there. Yes, there are videos out there. So should we play the song for Barbie? Why did it just play that? I didn't say to play that one. I'm not lying about videos being out there. Yes, I do like Foxy. Yes, this is standing next to you, but I guess I'll let it play. Probably. I have had a lot of TikTok shops want to send me free makeup stuff, so I might get some of that and review it for you guys if you want me to. It's in store tomorrow, I think. Like crazy? Now people are requesting K-pop. Dye my hair red? I don't know. Hey, take off. Did someone say, do you have any? No, I don't have any shirts because I haven't been able to afford to get some. But when I'm able to, I will buy my own merch so I can wear it. Can I do that? can't deny I'm right. Think you can deny I swear to God that just the time I thought. Be real here standing next to you. Standing in the fire next to you. It was deeper than the rain, deeper than the pain. Like he admits that the day could take away. Tick, 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 tick off. Standing next to you. I do. Next to you. Standing next to you. I played that one last night. Have I ever watched Formula One? No. Well, I might have. I'm not really into racing. Well, I mean, if it's racing games, sure, but... Yeah. It's like Sophia, but with a T. That's how you pronounce it. You mean, when did I start the live? It's probably been about almost an hour. I think. I don't know. I can swipe that way and check, but I'm not going to. Pray for I can't even say it. I was like, Oscar Pestry win? Okay. I'll be praying. Even though I don't watch Formula One, I've only think I've seen it more than a few times. Laughing with no money? I have money, so I can laugh. I don't know how much longer I'm going to be live for. Okay, anyways, let's play. There he is. Yes, I heard. I saw Noah made a video about that party, that Riz party thing. Yes, I do like Garnet from Steven Universe. I had to play this song. When can I start doing longer lives? I am doing longer lives. But sometimes I just get tired. The Fortnite song. I'm gonna ruin it for you because you said that. I'm just kidding. Wait, I have to see this. I think that was Ry Rault. Same. Actually, Rydell Lynch and my friend has met R5 five times. She met R5 she's met every single person from Austin and Ellie except for Ronnie Rodriguez, but she did meet Callum Worthy. She has met Laura Morano. Actually, I met Laura Morano over Zoom. That's why I got on Zoom, because my friend was like, I'm doing this Zoom party for Laura Morano's songs, and I knew Laura Morano would hop in because she's like really nice friends. Well, not friends, but she's really nice with my friend. So I joined because I knew she was gonna join, and my laptop had died. I was like, oh crap. So I had like the desktop, and I ran and I got on the desktop because I was like, oh crap, she's gonna join. Right when I joined, she was in there and I was like, oh hey. I was like, I'm sorry, my laptop died. She was really nice too. She was a really, really nice person to meet. And then there was like so much happening because I like was like, hold on, because like I told my brother, I was like, Laura Morano's on the Zoom. And then we took a picture, which I have archived in my Insta story, but she's a really nice person to meet. Am I a celebrity chaser? No. I don't know any information about celebrities, where they're at, where they're going to be. Nope, not me. I'm not one of those people. It's just that my friend is like, you know, real nice or to Laura, and Laura's real nice to her. They're not like friends, you know, but yeah, I was like, that's cool. And so then my friend has been to like 5 R5 concerts and met R5 all 5 times. Because she's a huge Austin and Ellie fan, so yeah. And actually, my friend had Justin Bieber following her on Twitter too, and she doesn't even know why. She was like, Justin Bieber follows me on Twitter. I was like, you're lying. She was like, no, I don't know why he follows me. And I was like, why does he follow you for? And she's like, I don't know. He just followed me. I was like, that's crazy. Oh, what is it playing? Right now. Get me stuck. You know what? I will listen to this, I guess. Do you eat onion rings? Onions are nasty in general, so no, I do not eat onion rings. Get my lashes done? I was thinking on buying some. Onions are nasty! That's like people eating Funyuns. I will never understand that. To me, okay, well, caramelized onions or cooked onions are good because I will eat them in my Whataburger melt, the patty melt or whatever it is that I always love to get from Whataburger. I will eat onions in that, but as far as uncooked onions, they're nasty. Onion rings are fried though, but I don't like onion rings. That's the thing, like that, I won't eat it. But I mean like caramelized or brown, like diced onions. But if it's onion rings, I won't like it. It's fried onion rings. Or yeah, it's fried onions, and I don't like, in general, I don't like that. My mom does. My mom loves onion rings. My mom's the one that eats Funyuns. Oh, I'm sorry. Filet mignon sounds good. Do you read your emails? Only if they're important. If not, I just delete them. Oh, do they? Mm-hmm. Yes, I have straightened my hair before. Actually, I have pictures of me with straightened hair. My Facebook profile picture, which I've had for years, I took that when I was in college and my hair was straight. Oh, you almost got me with that one. I almost read that one. If you guys want to, I think there's wigs on my wish list, but don't get anything from my wish list because I don't know if anyone has. Yeah, I haven't changed the address. I haven't even changed anything on the wish list. I forgot. Oops. I need to do that. I was going for business. I went to university. I got accepted to UNM. Yep, I got accepted to UNM. And if you don't believe me, you can look up my full name. It says alum. I did go to UNM. Yes, I did. I got accepted. Oh. No. You're not listening anymore. Should I play this one? I guess. I went for business, but I had to drop out because I couldn't afford it. I was on lottery scholarship. Because I applied for FAFSA. Yeah, well, I don't know. Anyways, I never finished because I had to drop out, but I did go to UNM. Like, if you search on my name, it does come up. I went right out of high school in 2013, and I only did like one semester because I couldn't afford it. I stayed in a dorm. Did you just call me Trisha Paytas? I'm gonna block you for that one. That's an insult. Whoa. God. Yes, University of New Mexico. Everyone's a lobo. Wolf, wolf, wolf. That's the... thing they do at games. Trisha is mom, but she had a lot of controversies. You have to remember, she pretended to be trans. She pretended to have identity disorder. What was it? She lied about Mr. Riney, which was one of her teachers, saying that he did stuff to her when he did it. And he was actually a veteran that was no longer living at the time. And they said to apologize to Mr. Riney's family. On top of that, she's done a lot of stuff. Yes, she was. People said she was literally, unless... She literally would do stuff to be problematic. She wasn't really... like, behind what she was doing. Like, when she became spiritual and she wanted to learn spirituality, she wasn't doing it because she wanted to learn. She was trying to be problematic every chance she got. She's rich, that matters. I'm like someone. Oh, you're pointing the finger at me. Problematic people. Oh, look, it's Unidos or whatever his name is. He did a commercial for Taco Bell. The one TikToker on here. You know what I'm talking about. I was only for a semester. That's how long I was in university because I couldn't afford it. Either Jenny or Rosé. It's literally my bias from Blackpink. Sorry, comments are flying. I'm trying to answer everyone's questions. It is. Fine, I'll play JoJo Siwa, but I don't like it. Why? Why do you guys want to hear that? My ears, they're going to be bleeding. You know how many times I've heard that over, I was going to say K-pop, not K-pop, over Instagram? I've already seen some of the music video. Oh, there it is. Oh, look, I'll play Taylor Swift, Karma. You know what? I'll play this song that is with Karma, too, so. No. It's freezing. Maybe it's a sign. Don't watch it. It's not even playing. No, I'm not going to play Taylor Swift. I'm going to play another song. Why? Why do I have to hear this? Go to sleep? I'm not tired. But I will have to get off and go to sleep. Help. Help me. I'm the one who controls this. I don't have to listen to this. You can't make me listen to this. I can't do the dance, but she's too like dead or something. Oh, sorry. It clicked out of there. I accidentally pressed this one. Back on 74th Street. Okay, I'll go back. Aren't you like, because I don't. Oh, we could play Usher. Back on 74th Street. Okay, let's go to where we were. I'm gonna go halfway, so it's almost over. What is that noise? It's windy outside. I don't even know where we were. I'll play it from right there. I'm sorry, I'm just trying to get over. I'm sorry, I was zoned out. I wasn't even paying attention. Not even to the music video. I was thinking of something in my head. But I'm so sad. I'm not that sad. I didn't even do anything, Joe. If that's the Joe that I'm thinking of, that is always negative in my comment sections. Like, do you have anything better to do with your life than be a hater, Joe? I mean, I would be angry too if I had no hairline. If my hairline was receded and pushed back, I'd be angry too. She thinks doing her makeup like Gene Simmons makes her edgy. My hair literally looks like Gene Simmons. Do not come for me. If someone says I look like Gene Simmons, I'm blocking you. and I'm not, it's not a debate. I'm blocking you, okay? That's an insult. Don't add insult to injury. Oh, Jesus. Oh, I'm blocking you. Someone said Gene Simmons blocked. I'm just kidding. Block them right now. Here's the, this one.
That's ludicrous, but I got you. Hang on. Like a good...
is Steven Universe.
Yes.
How can you know right when I need Steven Universe? How can you know right when I need probably one day if I have enough money to do so. I don't know when the next cooking ones is. Oh, not that song. How old is that song by Brooklyn? I remember people had an issue with it when it came out. Right when I needed you, you never know. Always show me to you. Oh, we have a stove. Surprise. Feel it so cold. I'm not gonna play it. There's another song I wanna play. Guys, I'm not adding any more mods. Sorry. Take yourself, come. Is that that song like the double Dutch bus going down the streets? The double Dutch bus. The double Dutch bus. Is that the song you're talking about? Music. It's a bulgazee. The double Dutch bus. The double Dutch. No, that's what they say in this. I have to play double Dutch bus, then you'll know what I'm talking about. Because unless you've heard it, you don't know what I'm talking about. There's another song I was going to play. Yes, we did on my live stream. Oops. I meant to fight the comments. Gotta have it just the way that I go. Keep me open, I'll be hoping that I'm gonna be with that girl. That girl, she's killing me. I didn't say anyone stole my phone, so don't put names out there. Lord, help them. I said, someone took my phone, and I said, I think I might know who it was, but I didn't say a specific person, and I didn't say anyone. Why do you just assume things? Get excited because you're my girl. Just because I said a girl stole it, because I didn't even say a girl stole it. Someone said she sold your phone, and I read it, and then I said, oh, even if she sold my phone, and then I said, that's not who I'm talking about. And then I said, I never even specified if it was a she, and even so, you can't just assume names, so don't throw that out there. Like, people just want to start drama where there isn't any. And I'm not going to hear it from people because you're throwing their name out there. Because I know what you're going to do. You're going to be like, go over there and be like, oh, she's talking about you. I'm not talking about anyone, so don't do that. It gets annoying. No, it just... that Android, I keep telling you guys... all it had was screenshots from the Discord and stuff. That's all it had. No, I've been live for a while. So, yeah. Get a new phone. I have my iPhone, but that Android had all my, evidence from the Discord, and I did tell the police because I made a police report. Little plate. Oh, hold on. I'm not ignoring you. I was typing up a sound and playing it. Hey. You probably have to turn your notifications off and back on if it doesn't notify you. That usually works. My hair, no, my straightener's in storage. I can't. I mean, I could because I have that like part, but I don't have the brush or like that blow dryer has a straightener thing. Yes, I do have merch link in my Beacons link. It says Chew Line, and if you click it, that's my merch. To see. I should even laugh at that. I'm not even gonna. That comment made me laugh. Are you calling a person a dog? or a pet. Oh, that would literally anger me if someone called me a pet. Oh, does it? That's kind of cool. Not for me. Sometimes it puts Sophia. I have a bunch of songs. That's why it's hard to have a favorite. No way, because I'm not giving my address out. You mistake me for a fool. Hey, you're asking me why was it funny? I thought it was funny because they thought I got a new pet. I didn't get a new pet. I can't help that unironically it was funny because they thought I had a pet. I'm not living with anyone. Except my family. Well, obviously, what people are talking about pertaining to that name, they could obviously tell it's not about a pet. But, okay. Clearly, why would they even have to ask? You're such a gay hoe. I love it. I'll play double Dutch Bush after this because you guys will understand what I was saying. I'm not supporting Kanye. I'm not even playing that song. It popped up in the thing. I like vanilla scented perfumes. My favorite flavor of ice cream is cookies and cream. I'm not stopping my mom from going live. What's can you describe how you That's a weird account. Because you have zero following, zero followers. That's suspicious. And you keep mentioning one specific person. As my mom would, she doesn't go live. You could ask her. I love you, Drew Hill. I love you, Drew Hill. Match my stuff. I need to get more bandanas that match. I said I was gonna play Double Dutch Bus, but I have to play this one. When I can, guys, I'll try to do more food reviews. I'll play the Double Dutch Bus after this. Thank you. Fortnite with people. I do, but only certain people I know. Because I don't. The second night I am, but if anyone's streaming tomorrow, then probably. Because someone said they're going to stream the second night or the second day of WrestleMania. So, if someone's streaming tomorrow, I might. No, you can't add me on Fortnite. I think I turned that off. Because people kept adding me and I got annoyed. No, I don't. Yeah, she does have a hammer. I don't know, they say a lot of players on their course. Yes, I will play. That person that said teams whatever and team whatever, like, is there beef or something? He's so extra for nothing. That girl actually that was in that music video ended up on drugs. Okay, you're double Dutch bus. My mom actually likes this song. Funny enough. The double Dutch bus going down the street. Music is a cute. Like, you would have. That's why it sounds like gibberish, because you have to hear the song to understand. Give me a ho if you got your funky bus fare. Oh, ho. Yeah, see, I told you, my mom's already laughing.
You fight, and this is your only one, the mark
of fight. I am, because someone told me to play it. They told me to play that song, not me. They said play it. Yes, I do like Adam Sandler. Get on the bus, pay your fare. Not that's Randall. Oh my god. Every time my mom sees Randall live, she laughs. My mom can't hear, I'm not yelling at her. No, Randall's not live. She was talking about the guy that sings the song. Or the guy with the cowboy hat. She was like, that's Randall. Yes, I do. Are you asking that stupid question? Why do you bring up an old, some old that Aunt Karen said on a live stream when I went live with her? Like, that's old. Like, are you ever gonna talk about anything new? Like, it's so annoying. Do you love yourself? No, I don't think you do. Like, that's so annoying. You can't tell someone whether they love themselves or not. See? Now you know what the gibberish was. That's why someone was like, is this, are you singing gibberish? Gazette. 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 You say, is it Gazette? Gazette. Gazette. I told you. You had to hear the song to understand. You have been annoying. I'm blocking you. Huh. And I don't think that person was even talking about me, but anyways, you're still getting blocked. You do know that person called me an ugly bitch once because they mistook one of my comments and I didn't even get upset over it. Huh? He wasn't. Because if he was, then why is he still following me? Oh, mad. He was not even talking to me, but okay. No, he wasn't. I would know, I was paying attention. And there was people in the comment section. There was people in the comment section being disgusting because they kept bringing up his record and they kept putting it as one of those where people, if people comment like on Bigo, so they have where if you pay for a comment and you have people comment it, what they will do is they comment that over and over again to get coins. And because it was blocked, people couldn't do that, and people was not going to do that anyways. They wanted people to spam about his record to get coins. They paid for that. And since the words were blocked anyways, and people was not going to do it, yeah, there was people in the comment section. So I don't know what people are talking about, because I clearly didn't hear that was said towards me. I clearly remember people were bringing up his record while I was up in the live because the Discord said go talk about his record, which I have proof of that. And I also have the proof of the Discord saying that he needs to go unalive himself because he told someone to unalive their self because they were talking about his kids, which he has every right to do so. So there's that. I don't know why people are tone policing how people react over what someone said about their children. If someone's talking about their kids, someone has every right to say what they say. Yeah, I have proof of everything the Discord was doing. They literally went in, they literally took advantage of the live to say go talk about his record because the only reason why they was up there is because they was mad at me because I'm guilty by association for being associated with someone they believe harmed their children, which is not even true. It's annoying. I was sent proof. And all they ever do is talk about him all day, every day, and talk about, I'm the one obsessed. I know you've still been talking about him because I have the proof of that. It's just so annoying. And these are the same people that talk about other people. Literally, I could care less. They literally went and they literally said, go talk about his record when I was up in the Beagle Live because I accidentally joined. And I said, you know what? I'm just going to stay up. And it literally didn't deter me or scare me away because I still would go, if he was going live on Beagle, I would be in there. That's not going to stop me. You're not going to go up there and lie because I'm guilty by association, which supposedly, this one chick that was up there, Young Donald, is trying to tell me to expose Nova and said they need my voice because I'm a larger person with a platform. And I said, you're literally trying to work. A PD30, but yet you want me to expose Nova. I said, I got my own situation. Why'd you go up there and lie on me? You should be apologizing to me. But, you know, I don't know if that's really Young Donald, the Young Donald from the live, but seriously. Like, it's so annoying. Like, you were in someone's space that you believed harmed their children, and then You literally use their platform to get views. And yet you're saying you never liked them. So why were you in their live stream in the first place? It's always weird to me. Like, that Discord has always been weird. Why does it keep going up there playing stop? It's so annoying. Like, I know what their motive was because I'm guilty by association. Because of what they believe he did to his kids. And it's just like, he didn't do anything to his kids. And they even admitted that's why they're trying to expose me. And I wouldn't put it past me if they were working with that leprechaun man to have him swatted. And I wouldn't put it past the Discord to be the ones doxing him in his live streams. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if they're the ones behind most of that, working with the other people who are horrible human beings. I wouldn't. Because the thing is that they've been talking about him a lot. If you're guilty by association, people harass you. That's what it is. Should I play The Freaks Come Out at Night? The Freaks Come Out at Night. The Freaks Come Out at Night. Because it's true. Oh, we have to play this song. No, the reason why people gave him the nickname Leprechaun is because if you mention his actual name, he comes and he starts harassing you and doxing you. Like he's doing other people. Specifically black women. You don't need to know who. He tried to follow me and I blocked him. So yeah, he tried to follow me once and I blocked him. And he went into someone's live stream and was like, she always talks about me all the time. I'm like, you are a lot older than I am and you're worried about me talking about you. I'm the least of your worries, sir. You should be worried about that photo you have in a bathtub with two kids. That's weird. I'm not exposing them because you guys want drama and then you'll go tell them I'm talking about them. Then he'll start harassing me and I don't want that. He'll start sending me cash apps. No, it's not him. It's somebody else. That he also harasses Genty. I'm not going to say who. They gave him the nickname Leprechaun, and we're going to leave it at that. That's how I know him from. This. Hold on, girls. I need to do something. Oh no, not that. Hold on. Let me go to my settings. Hold on, I have to figure out where I go because everything's changed. You will find it should be there. There we go. No. There we go. Why did it do that? Why does it? No. I want to do it. I think it's because I have too much. I think. No, I don't. It's. Hold on. Oh, it already exists. Okay, cool. There. No, because I'm not gonna be harassed. So if I have to block that name, I will. Like, this is not literally just some tee-hee-hee drama that you can go run and tell people I'm talking about them. This dude has literally stalked and harassed a minor and their mother. This is not something that you just tee-hee-hee. It's not fun and games. Do you really want to hurt me? Do you really want to make me cry? Like, if you're gonna say that and not spell it actually right, you're getting blocked. Goodbye. Because no one's gonna come into my live stream and type the N word a different way. It still makes you racist. If you are not black. if you are not black. Money can't buy you love. There we go. Oh no, no, I almost paused the live, hold on. Blocking keywords for my live. You have to play this song. The freaks come out at night. The freaks come out at night.
And I have late stage COPD.
I should play that song because here comes the freaks. I'm just kidding. But yeah, it was a commercial to quit smoking, even though I don't smoke. I didn't start anything. That's kind of rude. This is what used to be my favorite song. It still is, I mean. A wreck doesn't mean that I get to get out. It is a good song. The bigger the sound, the bigger the lies. You tell me I'm wrong. I don't think he's ever made one bad song. I mean, I don't like Rock With You, but it's not horrible. It's like your features, something make you wanna scream. Big time to cope with every loud is being nice. Please have mercy, cause I just can't take it. I don't really like Rock With You, but it's still a good song. I wanna rock with you. No, they don't. That's an insult. I look like JYP. I don't have Jesus. Off the Wall was a good album. Even though his most underrated album is the Invincible album. Think I'm not going insane. Just have confusions, don't they? Maybe? I don't know. I don't go out anywhere. Oh my God, I can't believe what I saw as I turned on the TV. This evening, I was disgusted by all the injustice. The dance that they do. That's the dance that they do. With such infusions that they make you wanna scream. This song, Scream. Everybody's screaming nice. Cause I just can't take it. Stop pressuring me. Stop pressuring me. Stop pressuring me. She has logged that part though. Cause this song was actually in from the Invincible album. I don't have snot. It's just like my nose is getting like runny, but it's not coming out. My ears don't touch my neck. Now all you got to do is walk away and pass me. No, I don't take sound requests. That's why I'm not playing what people are requesting. My hair, I'm not trying to hide my ears, my hair's just like that. Beyonce, but I don't take song requests because then everyone else is gonna be mad I didn't take their song. I should do $1 for song requests on Cash App. No, thanks. A lot of people do it on TikTok. This makes butterflies. Butterflies. Something woo-hoo. Thoughts on plastic surgery? People can get whatever plastic surgery they want, right? It's people's bodies, people's choice. Just like we say with women, right? Women could do what they want with their bodies, their body, their choice. Plastic surgery was, I don't want to say invented, but plastic surgery was used during the time of war. Yes, I do listen to TLC. So plastic surgery was used during war times to help fix disfigurement in your face. If something happened to you during the war, they would take skin from other places and they would graft it on your face. So like if something happened to your face in the war, they will take a part of your skin, like either from your arm or from wherever they could, where they were able to, like, the skin would stretch back. So if they took a skin, if they took a piece of skin from somewhere, they wouldn't take it from where they couldn't fix that part with other skin, if that makes sense. So they're not taking from where it'll leave like gaping holes and stuff. So they would use plastic surgery to fix disfigurement in people's faces during the war. People started using plastic surgery for other things, and then it got out of hand. I think, I can't say people go too far with plastic surgery because it's their choice. But then again, sometimes when I see something, I'm like, that's too far. But then again, I didn't pay for it, so why should I care? Like bazooka arms, if you've ever seen that guy. Like, I feel that guy's killing himself, and I think when it comes to that, I don't think it's technically plastic surgery. It is, like, steroids or whatever it is he's injecting into his arms. Like, that's crazy. Yeah, you've never heard of that guy called Bazooka Arms? Like, he's a guy that has, like, a weird-looking face because of plastic surgery. And his name is Bazooka Arms, and he always says something weird. And sometimes on lives, you will see him nod off because whatever he's injecting into his body is harming him. He'll be like... And then his arms are just, like, purple in some places. Like, it's purple because of what he's doing to himself. No, I would never get plastic surgery. My nose is, like, ready now. Like, my nose, I was hit with a water hose. Otherwise, my nose wouldn't look so big. It would probably be a lot smaller, but... Yeah, I was hit in the nose with a water hose. And I just kept bleeding. It wouldn't stop. So my mom called the fire department, and they came and had to help me. This was when I was in elementary school. This kid, I'm trying to remember his name. Anyways, Tyler, I think his name was. No, it wasn't. My mom used to, so a long time ago, when we were in elementary school, my mom used to babysit these kids for their mother, who was a truck driver, who would work and would ask my mom to watch the kids. Well, my mom ended up finding out that she was watching the kids while the mother was going to sleep with men. And she said, I'm no longer watching these kids anymore. And her son, he would always bully me. And one day we were just playing with the water hose and he went whack. And he hit me right in the nose and I started bleeding. My dad got so mad. He ended up... He got mad and he told him, come here, because he was mad at him. And he refused to come down. He got up on the roof somehow. On top of the apartment roof and he was refusing to come down. And so then they got in a car and fled. They left. They left. They didn't come back. Cause she knew what her son did was wrong. She was the one. She tried to pick a fight with my father, and then tried to pick a fight with my mom, because my mom said that she was no longer gonna watch her kids, because she was out there sleeping with men instead of going to work. And my mom would feed her kids dinner and would give them lunch. We would eat lunch and dinner, and then she would send them home whenever their mom came from work. So, yeah. Then she, yeah. And the type of bullying I received where I live was disgusting bullying, because there's no reason why teenagers should be talking about an elementary school kid's private area like that. Yeah, that was not comments to be making to someone at that age. That's weird. Mm-hmm. I was, because it was like, what was it? It was like, not really dark. The sun was kind of going down. I was outside. It was this girl and this guy. He would always bully me. I forgot his name. It was like three of them, or it might have been him and her. And he was like, oh, you have so much. I spoke about that, and I was like, that's not something you tell someone who's at elementary school. You're in middle school? You're like... They thought it was a funny joke. They thought this was something that was funny. That's not funny to tell an elementary school kid. Like, I was like, what? 9, 10? That's weird. That is weird comments to be making. Especially because, yeah, that's weird. Oh, can you stand the rain? That's all it goes. Like, it is. They were talking about my pubic hair, and they were saying stuff like, oh, I bet you have a forest or a jungle down there, you could braid it. And I was like, to me, that was kind of hurtful, because I didn't really understand, and they were laughing like it was funny. So I was getting bullied. I didn't think of it as anything like weird until now, like until you're older, you know, and then you realize comments like that are not okay, especially you're in middle school, high school, and you're saying this to someone who is in elementary school who's 9 or 10. Like, that's, why do you even think of elementary or a minor's privates? Like, if you're in middle school, that's weird, especially because I was in elementary school. That's not comments you make to someone at that age. Especially because I didn't really understand what they were saying, because at the time, I was like 9 or 10. I didn't really understand. Obviously, I'm not old enough to know that stuff, because in middle school, you learn, you know, because you take, health class, and they teach you anatomy and stuff like that. But I wasn't even in middle school. I was still in elementary school. Like, do parents even teach their kids? Like, that's not remarks you say to someone, but okay. Like, at the time, I didn't say anything to my parents, or didn't say anything to anyone, because I just took it as bullying. You know, I didn't understand. So, I didn't say anything. I just kept that to myself. Considering the fact that I was sexualized a lot when I was 9 or 10. Like, some people would just say remarks that, you know, they shouldn't say. Like, you shouldn't be talking to someone like that. But, you know.
This is
my nose just keeps wanting to. My nose just keeps wanting to run. Sorry. If you are triggered, guys, I'm sorry. It's just a trigger warning. And also, guys, you have to understand that on this app, people are not responsible for your triggers. And I'm going to say it again. I am not responsible for your triggers. If you do get triggered, please take a moment and leave. But people on this app shouldn't have to be responsible for people's triggers. And I do say trigger warning a lot, but you do have to understand that sometimes it's bound to happen where you might get triggered. And if it's something where you get triggered, I wasn't going to say it like that because that sounds mean. That's not what I was going to try to say, is like, seek help. That's kind of rude. I was going to say like that. I'm trying to think of what I was going to say, and it was in my head, and I was like, no, that's not what. But you do need to talk it out and actually work through your but you work through your trigger. If you're triggered, please take a moment and leave the live and then come back. Oh, we lost connection. Sorry, we lost connection, guys. My bad, it was lagging. But if you do get triggered, please take a moment to leave the person's live and take a moment and then come back, because I hear it on people's lives all the time. They always say, I'm not responsible for people's triggers, because I always see when people say, well, I was triggered by that. But you can't blame the person because they're not responsible for someone's triggers. If it's looping, you might have to leave and come back. My phone does that. It leaves or it loops sometimes, and I'll just leave and come back. Trauma dumping, it depends why the person is trauma dumping. If they're just trauma dumping in a conversation that has nothing to do with trauma, then yeah, but we were talking about, I was talking about stuff. So if the conversation was not needed for it, then of course. But if it's like let's say someone's talking about race, and somebody joins the live stream and says, well, I think I could face racism because I have trauma, because one time when I was little, and it was about race, and then they start trauma dumping, there's a difference. If, like, people start trauma dumping in a debate, then it's like, why would you do that? Like, not needed. And a lot of white people, okay, don't come for me. I'm not trying to be rude, but a lot of white people tend to trauma dump in spaces, black spaces, when they talk about race and center themselves. And sometimes, we understand, but you have to realize not to do that. And no, that was not trauma dumping. I was just talking about something that happened to me when I was younger. That's a trauma dumping. I hate when people do that. Because I said I'm not responsible for people's triggers, they try to find something else. Like, oh, well, then you're trauma dump. Like, then you'll find something else. Like, don't do that. Thank you. Are those dancing twins? Yeah, well, I'm not a DNA test. I'm doing an ancestry test for myself, not for people. But it would be pretty cool to share my ancestry test results. Thank you. I didn't say you was my therapist, so please don't do that. Like, this is the thing that's annoying. When you have other influencers, especially large influencers that talk about things that, oh, I'm sorry that happened to you. But with certain people, it's always like, oh, it's trauma dumping. Like, I hate the selective, and it's selective outrage. And I always use that word a lot, but it is. Like, can we not do that? That gets frustrating. Because the conversation definitely warranted it at that time. This is America. You guys have to understand, a lot of influencers do that all the time. It's not weird to tell a story because maybe other people might have experienced something like that. That's not weird. I mean, to you it might be, and I can't control how you feel. That's how you feel. Shanaynay is the greatest character ever. There was,
You won't find confidence on any list of SUV features.
If
you... But there is one brand that has it in spades. And they back it up with a 10-year, 100,000-mile limited warranty.
Oh. Kia. I'm gonna play this last song and then probably gonna get off and go to sleep. My day was good. It's red, green, and... Yeah, it's just red. I mean, blue and green. Why did I say red and green? Does this look like red to you guys? My favorite Fortnite skin, well, what I have, I do like the Mecha Morty. But my favorite skin, well, I have several. Because the ones that I have is Mecha Morty. I have the Cos one, which are my favorite one. The Cos Peely, which is the... And then the regular Cos. And then Human Bill, which is the alien. I have all the Star Wars skins. Well, I bought them, but it's not on my account, so they're technically not mine. But, my top three are probably the Cos one, the Human Bill, and Mecha Morty. What am I doing for my 30th birthday? I don't know. I'm gonna see if there's a place that does free giveaways or something for my birthday. I don't know. No, I don't have the Gojo skin. I was gonna get that one, but then they didn't have it. And when they brought it back, I couldn't get it. I was like, I can't afford it. But I do have All Might. That's one of the anime skins I have is All Might. It is good on, this dance is good on Just Dance. Are you going to plan a party? No, because I don't have anyone to come to my party. You don't like this song? Oh, I do. Jesus. Jesus with the please. No, I don't want to throw a party for random people to show up. I'm sorry, I'm not going to do it. That's weird and uncomfortable and not safe. Well, anyways, guys, yes, I do play Overwatch. I haven't played in a long time, though, because I don't have my Xbox here. I have to get my Xbox. Once I get my Xbox, I will play again, hopefully. I get back into Fortnite, too. So, anyways, guys, I'm going to get ready to go to sleep. Have a good day or night where you guys are. I'll see you guys later. Thank you for liking. Thank you for commenting. Thank you for gifting. And I will see you guys later. Bye, guys. I'm gonna go to sleep. Yeah, I have to get some sleep, guys. But I need to get some good sleep. But anyways, guys, have a good day or night. I'll see you guys later. Bye, guys.